What's going on, everybody? Just as we here at Liberty Hangout, me, Caitlin Bennett, has been predicting, they're doing it again. Atlanta is burning once more. They set the Wendy's on fire this time. So I'm sure you guys have heard recently the new outrage mob, the new Black Lives Matter riots that are happening 24 hours after a black man was shot in the Wendy's parking lot in Atlanta. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about what the truth is. So, Wendy's called the cops on a man for sleeping in his car, blocking the drive-thru. So Wendy's called the cops because there was someone sleeping in a car in the drive-thru. The cops arrived and they identified that this man was 27-year-old Rayshard Brooks. They did a field sobriety test and the officers concluded he was probably drunk. He was under the influence of something, so they attempted to arrest him. You should be arresting someone who is drunk and behind the wheel. I agree with their actions. You should be doing that. They should not be behind the wheel if they're drunk. Get them to a hospital if he's passed out. So they tried to do the arrest. He resisted. It ended up into a fight, a brawl. Where, I don't know if you guys have seen the video, I'm not going to show it right now because I'm live, but he punches the officers. He punches the officers and he's able to tussle with them a lot. It's actually pretty shocking. There's two officers and then just Rayshard. So he ends up disarming one of his taser. Now, okay, just because you have a taser doesn't mean you get shot, right? Okay, whatever. He runs from them. He runs from them. And he's able to break free of the officers. He took off running with the taser in his hand. Now, he turns around and the mayor of Atlanta, a black woman, confirmed this. The video footage shows that he turned around, aimed, and then discharged the taser at the officers. If you have a firearm, this goes for a cop, this goes for anyone in general. It's almost kind of related to the Ahmaud Arbery case, which I have not given really many opinions on myself personally, but it's kind of related. If you are armed, if you have a firearm, and someone is firing something at you or coming at you, which would immobilize you, potentially disarm you from a firearm, you treat them as a threat. You have to make sure someone does not take your firearm from you. Imagine if he was able to fire and get that cop tased, immobilize him, and run off with his gun. No, no one deserves to die because they have a taser in their hand. But why is Black Lives Matter, like I said in my last video, guys, they take the not so best of people and they choose them to put in the spotlight. What is happening all over again 2 weeks later, and they're doing the exact same thing, taking someone who at this point, you know, this is a lot different than the George Floyd situation. He didn't disarm a cop, nothing like that. They're gonna take this man. They've set the Wendy's on fire. The Wendy's that called the cops on him, it's gone. It's in flames. It's gone. Look it up, guys. Look on Twitter. I have a lot of things I'm gonna be saying about this. If you notice, I'm being kind of censored right now, but I'm gonna be fully uncensored on libertyhangout.tv. Sign up if you wanna hear all of my thoughts later on when everything comes out. But oh my God, I feel like a fortune teller, guys. I literally said they're gonna do it again. That something's gonna come out soon. And Trump's rally is in a week. Wow, that's nice. Thanks, media. Thanks for pushing this one a week before his rally. Trump, if you change the rally again, I'm gonna be very bad. But going back to the case, I literally called it. They are doing exactly what they did. They see the person who did it. They see that it's a police officer and they burn down the Wendy's. How do you visibly see the person who did the thing that you're mad about and then go and punch your neighbor? It makes no sense, but they're doing it all over again and the media is gonna run with this. They're gonna run with this. I'm calling it, I'm being a fortune teller again because I was right the last time. They're gonna run with this. They're gonna say how good of a man he was. His attorney has already said that the protesters, not his attorney, I apologize because he's deceased. You can't have one. The family of Ray Shard's attorney did a press conference today talking about how, you know, he was just at his daughter's 8th birthday, and, you know, the riots didn't help, the protests didn't help, what else has to do? He insinuated we should get rid of the police and replace them with new officers. Whatever. You know, that's a whole nother issue. What I want to know is, why are we rioting and setting things on fire over someone who disarmed the police and was drunk in a car? He did not just run away and get shot unarmed. No, this is not an unarmed situation. He took something from the police that could immobilize them and run away with a gun, and he shot. So, I called it. It is not about police brutality. It's about the racial aspect of it, which does not exist. Doesn't exist. There are so many examples of police brutality we could put up from people of all color, yet they refuse to. They refuse to. And shame on the media for picking this up and acting like this was racially motivated when it was not. And if you think they shouldn't have been arresting a man who was drunk behind a wheel, then shame on you. Then shame on you. If you think that someone should have been allowed to fire a taser at an armed person, and if you take the police aspect out of this, guys, if you are armed and someone is doing something that could immobilize you and leave you to where someone could take your firearm, that's not a good situation. That's not a good situation. I wish the situation never happened. I wish his family had cared enough about him not to let him leave in a car drunk, not to let him be in that situation in general. I wish that were the case, but that's not reality. So here we are. We're burning people's businesses. We're burning shops down. We're burning cities down over a man who, quite frankly, doesn't deserve that. Doesn't deserve that kind of attention. And now we are going to hear Ray Shard Brooks as this awesome guy who was doing nothing wrong and didn't deserve anything like that. No, you don't deserve to die because you shoot a taser at someone. I'm not saying that. But you do deserve to be treated as a threat to an armed person. That's the bottom case of it, guys. I hope to God these people who say that they shouldn't have shot or anything like that, and they should have just tried to chase after him, I hope they seek out the full video because they're I don't know. I don't get it, guys. I don't know how someone could watch that and say, yeah, you should have just let him go. Shame on them. Yeah, absolutely. You did nothing wrong. So here we are. How about this? Instead of calling for police reform, why don't we call for family reform? Why don't we call for that? Why don't we call for reforms within our community to help each other? If we notice someone's getting in a car drunk, how about we say, oh, no, I don't think you should do that. I don't think you should do that. Why don't we do reform on our family structure when Black Lives Matter says in their own website they want to destroy the nuclear family in America? That is their biggest downfall. The absence of fathers in the Black community is their biggest downfall. Why don't we focus on family reform within these communities? If we put Black fathers back into Black families, I swear, guys, I promise you, if we just tried it, if we tried doing that as much as we try disbanding police departments or defunding police, things would be a lot better in this country for Black America. The number one problem for Black people is the absence of fathers in their home. So I'm proposing we start a reform of family structures in this country, in our communities, in our society. And it starts with not funding Black Lives Matter, who want to destroy the nuclear family in our country and everything else. So, okay, that's about everything I wanted to say. Make sure you guys go to caitlinbennett.org so you can support my work and I can come see you at these Trump rallies that are about to happen. I'm not sure which ones I'll be at, so, you know, keep an eye out and we can talk, we can meet, I can interview you and everything. So, Okay, those are my thoughts.
If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to like and share, hit that subscribe button, and click the notification bell so you won't miss any of our videos. If you want to support my work, you can become a patron at patreon.com/CaitlinBennett and receive cool perks like an autographed photo from me in the mail each month. Or you can go to CaitlinBennett.org and get up to 75% off and free shipping on supplements and merchandise to support my work and start living a healthy life. My favorite product, it's Turbo Force, because it gives me all the energy I need to make it through a long day of doing interviews. There are tons of other health supplements you can choose from to keep your body healthy during these uncertain times. And check out the website band.video to see uncensored content from conservative creators that have been erased from social media.